Let's dive into ultrasound physics. Join me as we discuss ultrasound beam artifacts. An artifact in ultrasound is an echo or a reflection that does not correspond to an actual structure, or an echo that is missing, or an echo that is in the wrong location, or echoes that are displaying the wrong characteristics, such as size, shape, or brightness. Ultrasound artifacts occur because one of the seven assumptions that ultrasound machines make about sound waves fails to occur. So what are these assumptions? Assumption one is that sound travels in a straight line. Assumption two, sound travels into the tissue, encounters a structure, and travels directly back to the transducer. Assumption three, sound travels at a constant speed in soft tissue, which is 1540 meters per second. Assumption four, echoes arise only from structures within the main ultrasound beam. Assumption five, the imaging plane is thin. Assumption six, the amount of time it takes an echo to return to the transducer determines the depth of a structure in the body. And assumption seven, sound attenuates at an even rate in the tissue. There are five categories of ultrasound artifacts that can occur when one of the seven assumptions about sound waves that the ultrasound machine makes fails to occur. Category one are ultrasound beam artifacts. Category two are multiple echo artifacts. Category three are velocity error artifacts. Category four are attenuation artifacts. And the last category are Doppler artifacts. Today, we're going to explore ultrasound beam artifacts, including side lobes, grating lobes, beam width artifact, and slice thickness artifact. What are ultrasound beam artifacts? Ultrasound beam artifacts occur because ultrasound is based on the premise that echoes arise only from structures within the main ultrasound beam, and the imaging plane is thin, laterally and elevationally. Ultrasound beam artifacts occur because in reality, the imaging plane has a third dimension, the elevational plane, and the ultrasound beam has a variable width. Echoes can be captured from structures outside of the main ultrasound beam, such as our side lobes and our grating lobes. Types of ultrasound beam artifacts are side lobes, grating lobes, beam width artifact, and slice thickness artifact. Our first two types of ultrasound beam artifacts are side lobes and grating lobes. These occur because low-energy ultrasound beams are sent out of the transducer at the same time as the main ultrasound beam. This results in structures outside of the main ultrasound beam being mapped into the main ultrasound beam. The ultrasound machine displays these artifactual echoes as if they had originated within the main ultrasound beam. This causes false or artifactual echoes to be displayed within structures on the ultrasound image. Most commonly, we see this as artifactual echoes within the bladder, gallbladder, cysts, blood vessels, any structures that are supposed to be anechoic. Echoes generated by these low energy side beams are weak compared to echoes from the main ultrasound beam. Our next type of artifact is known as beam width artifact. This is related to lateral resolution. An ultrasound beam begins as the same width as a transducer and then gradually narrows in the near field. Its narrowest region is the focal zone, with the focus being the smallest width within that region. After the focal zone, the ultrasound beam diverges. This is known as the far field. A structure outside the width of the main ultrasound beam, if it's highly reflective, will generate echoes that are assumed to originate within the main ultrasound beam. This results in artifactual echoes being placed within echo-free structures on an ultrasound, such as the bladder, gallbladder, vessels, cysts, anything that's anechoic. Adjusting the focus corrects for this artifact because it narrows the beam in that area, causing structures outside the beam to no longer produce echoes within the beam. Our last type of artifact in this category is our slice thickness artifact. This is related to elevational resolution, which is the height of the ultrasound beam. The ultrasound beam is not thin or flat like a sheet of paper. It has three dimensions: the lateral dimension, which is the width of the ultrasound beam, the axial dimension, which is the length of the ultrasound beam, and the elevational dimension, which is the height of the ultrasound beam. The height of the ultrasound beam is determined by the transducer. Structures above or below the beam can be mapped into the main ultrasound beam. This results in artifactual echoes within anechoic structures, such as cysts, vessels, bladder, etc. Interested in more ultrasound videos on artifacts? Check out our series on Wednesdays. Don't forget to like, comment, subscribe, and stay tuned for our next videos.